you guys hear me all right?
Yep.
There you go.
Yeah.
Is that better? All right. How's everybody doing today, this morning? All right, so kind of tired. I feel it. I was in high school 2 years ago. I know that feeling. So anyways, my my name is Cedar George-Parker. I come from the Tsleil-Waututh Nation and Tsleil-Waututh Tribe, which is right out of Seattle, Washington. And I'd like to welcome you to the land of the Tsleil-Waututh, Squamish, and Musqueam territory. And you know, it feels really good to see all these young faces out here, you know? It feels really, really good. And back in high schools, when I started questioning my government, when I started questioning my humanity, and I started to learn about all these environmental problems that were going on just a short 2 years ago. So, yeah, that's great that you guys are here. So always question, you know? Question your humanity and question who you are and question if you're really gonna let this pipeline come through your land, you know? Come through where you live, come through where you grew up, where you know everybody, where you know your friends, where you know these streets, where you go get, you know, your ice cream, your favorite pizza, you know. We gotta fight for that. We gotta fight for each other, you know. We gotta fight with each other because, you know, these companies have millions upon billions of dollars, rackings on rackings they have. But that's okay because we got back ends on back ends. And, you know, That's good, and it's really good to see everybody out here, you know, a bunch of young faces, and, you know, really try to work together, you know, really, really try to work together. It's so good to see everybody out here because, as you know, they want to have the pipeline come through Burnaby Mountain, and that's just devastating, you know, that's just devastating in itself, and we really, really need to help each other. So I really thank you guys for coming out here, you know, it's really good seeing all these young faces, you know, out here. And, you know, like I said, let's work together, you know, let's contact each other, stay in contact, you know, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is bringing us all together, you know. We have all these social media platforms that bring us together and should, you know, lead a way to a better environment or whatnot. Just even talking, you know, even what you're doing, just talking amongst each other, sharing information is just awesome. And, you know, that's just really great. And what else do I have to say? You know, really try to work with each other. That's all I want to say, you know. And it's really hard sometimes being out here because where I come from, you know, I love who I am and where I come from is I love my family, you know. I love my brothers and sisters. They're annoying, but I love them to death, you know. The happiest moments in my life are with them. And, you know, they're the reason why I fight, you know, they're the reason why I want to stop Kinder Morgan, they're the reason I want to stop oil pipelines and bring youth together, you know. One thing about me is what I'm doing is that, you know, I don't want to say I'm traveling the world, but I'm traveling around the world, I guess. And I'm really trying to bring youth together, you know, I'm really trying to bring the younger generation together to fight this, because it really is youth-led. You know, what's happening around the world is that I have noticed that it's youth are standing up. You know, youth are saying no more. We're standing up. We're being modern-day warriors. And a modern-day warrior to me is standing up. You know, standing up to the bully, standing up to these people and saying no means no. And just, like, putting your foot down and saying, like, you know, this ends right here. So let's be those warriors. Let's stand up together. Together we can do this, you know. Hit me up, the same contact, because I really, really want to bring the youth together. You know, we really need to get this going, and let's do it. So, you know, hit me up on Facebook or whatnot. Let's get things going. I'm willing to help, you know. I'm willing to answer any questions. I'm willing to talk to anybody here, you know. One person at a time, I'm willing to talk and exchange information or whatnot. So let's do that, you know. We really got to fight for the hurt and pain that we go through. We really got to fight for the love that we have for our family, you know. I'm sure all of us have a family member we love. Except you, no, I'm just kidding. But like, yeah, we all have someone that we love. We all have something that we love. And I'm sure it's all around the Vancouver area. And all of that is getting challenged by Kinder Morgan. You know, the pipeline trying to come through right through Burnaby Mountain, you know. And if an oil spill were to happen, it would affect 2.5 million people in the Vancouver area. And it would take 24 hours to get down to Seattle, where I'm from. And there is 3.5 million people, and that's crazy, that's ridiculous. Imagine drinking all that in your water. Kinder, when an oil spill happens, Christy Clark made Kinder Morgan promise that Kinder Morgan provides plastic bottled water. I mean, imagine taking a shower with bottled water, how long that would take, you know? Because, like, I remember waking up for school, man. I'm like, oh, I didn't like that. But, like, it would take a lot longer if they had the bottled water there, you know? Imagine showering like that. I wouldn't want to do it. Unless it was, like, lost, but... But otherwise, you know, like I said, thank you guys for being out here. Thank you guys for being those leaders. Thank you guys for standing up, you know. It makes my heart feel so well seeing all this youth out here, you know. And it feels so great having everybody come together, standing up against bullies, you know. Standing up against this corporate bully that's trying to take away our future for materialistic objects. They're trying to rob us for a materialistic object, money. You know, that's ridiculous. Like, how does that make you feel? How does that make you, you know? Like, question. Because I remember when there was a school shooting at my high school in the Seattle area. It made me question my humanity. It made me question who I am and what I believe in. And I started to learn about all these oil pipelines and whatnot. And I questioned my humanity and I said, am I going to let this happen? And I saw the effects of it, you know? It's really killing people. And it's killing the way of life, and it's really killing the oceans and the environment. And I said, and I questioned myself and my government, and I said, no, I'm not going to let this happen. You know, so what I want to say is, you know, question your guys' government. You know, question things. Question what's going on, because that's how we're going to change things. That's where change comes from, is where you question yourself, and if you're going to let something like this happen, you know, I'm not going to, so let's work together, you know? Hit me up. Like I said, I'm willing to talk to all of you guys, you know, one by one, or however it takes, you know. Let me put you guys on. Let's do something together. Together we could fight this. Together we could stand up. You know, together we could take a stand. You know, I know it's possible because I went to Standing Rock September. And I saw all these people sitting together. You know, I saw Christians sitting with Muslims, Natives sitting with Buddhists. And we all came together for something beautiful, for something that we could all fight for. And that's a future. We could all fight for our future. You know, that's what's going on now. CO2 emissions are raising every year. And, you know, together we can do it. It doesn't matter what you look like. We all want a future. It doesn't matter what you look like. We all have something that we love. We all have something, you know, or someone that we love. Let's fight for that love. Let's fight with each other. Let's fight for each other. My name is Cedar George-Parker. I'd like to say thank you for having me out here. And, you know, I also want to say, let's talk. Let's do it. You know, that's all we can do. But I'm done. Thank you guys very much for listening. You guys are a really good turnout. I'm kind of scared coming up here. Oh, high school students, man. I don't know where else in high school is. But you guys are really good, you know. To the teachers out there, your students are really well behaved. And it's really impressive, you know. So I think they deserve a day off. Thank you.